men who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless it. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless.
Thank you very much, everybody, and hello to Swanton and hello to Toledo, and I'm thrilled to be back in Ohio with thousands. And these guys are bad people, I swear. They never turn the cameras around, ever. Turn them around. Turn them around. They never turn. Look at them. They're just like a bunch of stiffs, real stiffs. Why don't you turn the cameras around for once, you know? You look back there, you can't see it. There's got to be. Feels like Madison Square Garden on the ground, except we have more people. Come up here. And we will make America great again. Thank you, Ohio. Get out and vote. Thank you.
To feel down, I said, young man, pick yourself off the ground. I said, young man, but you can hang out with all the boys. It's fun to stay in the YMCA. It's fun to have a good meal. You can do whatever you feel. Young man, are you listening to me? I said, young man, what do you wanna be? I said, young man, can't help.
Thank you. So as our nation mourns the loss of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, I will soon announce a nominee for the United States Supreme Court. They say it's the most important thing a president can do. I don't know. I think military maybe. You know, we rebuilt your military, $2.5 trillion. Great. We will fill that seat. It's going to go quickly. Probably announce. But for the people of Ohio, this is what you want. So it looks like we're going to have three, and it's going to be very exciting. It's exciting even for me. I'm going to look forward to it. Probably Saturday, we will announce the nominee, and it's somebody that you're going to have great respect for. Great respect. Thank you. Thank you. Big stuff. That's a big thing. You know, they set the course of our country for many years to come, whether it's on life or the Second Amendment or so many other things. They set the whole course of the country, a very important position, the most important. Joe Biden is review. If Joe Biden and the Democrats take power, they will pack the Supreme Court with far-left radicals who will unilaterally transform American society far beyond recognition. They will mutilate the law, disfigure the Constitution, and impose a socialist vision from the bench that could never pass at the ballot box. So they don't want to show the judges, because the only ones that he can put in are far-left radicals. And if he does, but so I turn on NBC with Lester Holt, another beauty. And they start with a hurricane. And then they went to something, and something else. And I'm saying, First Lady, this is getting a little embarrassing. We're 20 minutes into a half-hour show. They haven't mentioned the Nobel Peace Prize. And then it went through the whole show, and they never mentioned. Then I got nominated for a second one. They never mentioned. And when Barack Obama Barack Hussein Obama got nominated. Now, when Barack Hussein Obama got nominated, he didn't know why he was nominated. It was like right at the very beginning. He didn't do anything. He did nothing. And he got nominated. It was the biggest story I've ever seen. But that's okay.